Hello everyone, it's Juliana, and today I wanted to share with you my latest project. It is a baby girl journal meant for mothers with newborns or toddlers. And as you can see, I use this lovely golden book. It's an altered book. I've removed the classic golden spine and created my own spine. This book is so beautiful. It's done by the Wilkin sisters, and I think they're sisters. I'm sure if any of you know, let me know below in the comments. But many people love their image. The drawings are just amazing. So anyway, let's get started. Let's see, it's got a hitch post latch, a hitch post, and a yellow elastic that keeps it nice and secure. I found that over time, because I was looking at some of my other journals, that with the hitch post, the books tend to, they're not as chunky, and you can actually fit quite a bit in with the hitch post. Anyway, let's see. The measurements are, like all golden books, 6 inches across, and I think it's 8 inches down. So here's the spine. Let me show you the spine. Here, if I can back out a bit. This spine has these wonderful vintage groovy buttons on it. It's got visible sewing of the spine. You can see I use a yellow embroidery floss. And then I made this charm. It's held on by a ball chain. Guess I should bring that in closer. It's a ball chain. And I actually got this idea from, I believe it's, I know her last name. It's either Denise Trapp or Diana Trapp. Anyway, excuse me, Miss Trapp. I can't remember at the moment. She does wonder. I'm going to post her link below because she makes amazing journals. And so on this, I use a connector ring to hold all the charms. There's quite a few. There's this adorable bell that's a kitty cat. I got it from an Etsy store years ago, and unfortunately they closed. There's a vintage key. There's a little carriage. Let's see, there's a little, whoops. Anyway, there's a pacifier, and there's a little, it's hard to show you, sorry, a little teddy. Anyway, what else is on there? There's one more thing, I think, a pacifier carriage, oh, and a diaper pen. Anyway, that wasn't such a great showing, was it? Sorry about that. Anyway, let's open up. Oh, they're book corners. The corners were a little dog-eared, but they weren't so bad. But I thought it would look better presentation. So you open up. Let me move this over. And I've got decorative paper on the inside cover, but I cut out a circle so you could see this classic place where you can write your name. This little golden book belongs to. So whoever gets this journal can put their name in it. This image, this from a parenting magazine from the 50s. I own it and I scanned it and I made a smaller image to put on the paper. And then there's this beautiful trim at the bottom. So So, yeah, and I did a lot of stitching throughout. So you'll see the sewing. I love the sewing in journals because it just gives it another layer to the page. So here's a little tuck spot, and inside is a vintage welcome, I think it's from the 50s, welcoming card. Just arrived at the home, and it says the name. And then I've made a tag with a cherry on it. This lovely image on the left. Two pink flaps. And here's a vintage image. This is Authentic Ephemera from the magazine. This is a form from a automobile shop from like the 50s. So I've got another tuck spot here. It says first stuffed animal. It's got this cute little heart and this adorable image of this little girl picking flowers. And then I have a picture of a puppy and a little kitten. So everything's very sweet and cute. This is a pocket, an envelope, and I made this journal card. So, and everything, all the backing has coffee dyed paper that I glued to the back so you can write on it. Old vintage paper, coffee dyed paper. Most of the paper is coffee dyed. This is a little two kittens in the corner. Oh, this is cute. This is a little, can you see this? It's a little chihuahua in a cup. It's one of my newest stamps that I bought myself. More kitty cat and kitten. The vintage magazine. There's lots of space to write. It's not overly embellished, but it has some embellishing, which I think is good because people like to put things in their journal. So there is a side pocket here with another journaling card with a sweet image. With stitching around and the coffee dyed paper. This is so cute. It says teething pains. It's got a little baby there. So the next signature, the second signature, has this lace pocket that I've sewn on. It's a vintage lace and another journaling card. Whoops. Another journaling card. I hope that's in focus. With coffee dyed paper slipped in. A vintage arithmetic card, flash card. So it's a mix of old and new, and I've done some stamping throughout. This is actually a, excuse me, is from a Cuba. I bought this in Cuba a couple years ago. I buy a lot of things that when I travel, I look for markets where I can find old books, and I have an affinity for vintage children's books. So this is from Cuba, but it was printed, I believe, in Czechoslovakia, the old Czechoslovakia. Anyway, and these little girls in their dresses is from a French magazine that I picked up in Buenos Aires last year. It's got these groovy illustrations. Another tuck spot with a journaling card. And And this is a cupcake holder liner, and it says Bloom.